This is the food preparation for the Christmas Eve dinner.
Red cabbage.
Red cabbage.
What do you have, Nina?
Red cabbage.
Yes, you
I
do.
I have red cabbage in my hand. We're not going to eat this. We're going to throw this away because it's the outer leaf.
That's
we
right.
only want the best for
right.
the red cabbage.
But then you don't have turkey.
And what?
You have goose.
What are you doing?
I'm cutting the red cabbage. Preparing.
Uh-huh.
And I'm being Danish and American because nobody here likes goose. So we will have turkey, that's American.
Uh-huh.
And red cabbage, that's Danish.
Uh-huh.
And sweet potatoes, which are American. And riz a la main, which is Danish.
Okay. Sweet potatoes.
Ooh.
That's okay, Peter.
That's
I'll clean
all
it
right.
up. Are the sweet potatoes. This is what we're going to eat at dinner tonight. And these are absolutely delicious. And you put butter on them and sugar and you just eat them all up. And look at all the sweet potatoes we've got in the sink here.
Yeah.
We have quite a bit of sweet potatoes here.
A lot.
So many. But there's a lot of people, so we'll probably eat them all up.
And that's how you make red cabbage?
Yep. But that we didn't do in Denmark, because we didn't have a cuisinier. We did it by hand with a knife, okay?
Can you imagine doing all that by hand? You would have to start days and days ahead of time.
Well, it is, doesn't, I mean, Ralphie does it by hand in about a half an hour, but
yeah.
I'm not that fast.
Hi.
Hello, come in. Did you go Christmas shopping?
Hey, let's do this.
What is the book called?
20. T. Come on, Dad. Where do you do kidnap?
What is that, Tim?
Tiger Force. I gave it to Chris.
Oh, yeah.
And Timmy's
you gotta show it to your dad and look at him.
Dad, can Emily open this? Emily, open this.
Adjustment too. Can you see
Dad, Emily got
focus?
This.
I know.
Wow, you want to put them on, you little chili there, young girl?
these are trash?
That's trash, yeah.
That's the one. Marie, that's the
one. Oh, that's beautiful, Marie.
Yeah. Oh, sweetheart.
Hungry
hippos!
What's that?
Oh, I know. Is that for you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good game, huh?
Oh, that's me.
You like
that?
Yeah.
Jimmy, look!
I know the monorail.
You can see it now.
Whoa.
What's
that?
Look at this.
Timmy, what is that?
It's
an electric.
America, some books are us.
Tim, come here. Remember?
What is it?
Thank you, Marie.
Oh.
But it's two players.
What is it?
One or two.
Emily, here's a present for you. Toto Nicapan, Guatemala, blanket jacket, hand-woven wool.
To Lisa. Yeah. Thank you, Marie.
Oh, you're welcome. It smells so sweet.
What is it, Chris?
Oh, good.
Yes.
What?
Guys, thank you.
Pinball.
Look at this.
Here, Chris, why don't you give your mom this then?
Where's the other thing from the mom off? I can't find it.
I'm going to look at the restaurant supply store.
I can't find all my presents from
the mom. Nope. That was nice, isn't that? All right. Yeah, that one's good too, but these ones here just came with it.
Well, they're okay.
Are you getting to the bottom of it?
I think.
Yeah. Bottom of the paper.
Wow.
Yeah, we have to make sure when we make the paper.
Peter.
Dad, that's disgusting.
What's going on in the
paper? Oh, I got it. This is fantastic.
Oh, hey, Marie.
That's handmade in gold by C.D. Stark by Charles. Oh my God!
Thank you.
There are only four. We couldn't get.
Peter, would you like your present?
Yes.
Well, here now. You just reach into here and take it right out. There you go.
We got some here.
Oh, there's
some.
Oh,
let's see what's in the preparation.
It's an angelfish.
Emily, here's something else for you from Tim and Chris.
Oh, look. Yeah. Let's open it.
Oh, there's something underneath.
Today is April 2nd, 1989. Emily's awake.
I'm Ninja Timmy Larson.
Ninja Man strikes.
We shall be taking a tour on my number one beast out of five.
Right on the side of the street.
Go, Emily!
I
Yeah?
Well, man, space trolley.
Going to cross it.
A little book.
Isn't it awesome?
When you go, the one we made, you go over the water.
No!
No thanks.
Sorry. Harry Robinson.
Where'd he go?
Hey, nothing.
You want to go on?
Yeah, take me. Get me.
Yeah, you can come on here. Come on here, Emily.
Where are you? Fallen into the mud puddle?
Yep, I went once.
Completely?
I've done it twice and then twice.
We slided from right there in the middle of the mud puddle. We went together.
And I did it twice and he was taking it off and I was going and he fell. And I fell and I went smack. Right?
Hey, Dad, look. Dad.
Then you want to help?
I'm watching. Emily, you want to go on the rope? What?
Da-dee-da.
Get back a little, then it's focused
on
you.
I'm gonna follow Emily.
Get to touch it.
Chris can hold it all the time.
I know. Let me just get Emily
over
here.
Touch it.
I just want to get
Emily by the animals. Just a quick shot over here.
Aaron, one of your favorite tools.
Hey, Aaron, what's
Emily, look! Sheep! What? Wait, please don't grab it when I'm doing it. Just wait. I will let you do it. I promise. I promise. This is a good shot. Look at her. Her and the sheep. Let's go see Chris. Let's go watch him on his bike. Emily.
Can I do it now, Dad? Can I do it now, Dad?
See your hand.
Show me
your hand. Right there. Right there. Show me your hand.
And then we'll say, look at you, Emily, almost 2 years old, and you're still nursing. Right? Almost 2 years old.
Dad, tape my ear. Can I do it now, Dad?
Let's see your belly button.
No! Yeah, don't see my underwear.
Let me see your belly button.
Show Daddy your nose. Show Daddy your boo-boo.
Got a boo-boo?
And her lip. Show Daddy your eyes.
Where's
show
your
eyes.
Yeah. I want to do it.
Get it. She says I'm too old for that.
Okay.
Are you feeling him like that?
There he is. Good feeling.
Yes, I want to do it.
Give it to... Be sure to get it right in his face like this.
Dad,
go away, mad dog.
Do
Emily, look at Daddy. Tell Daddy, go away. I'm busy. What are you doing?
Dad,
I went to Rebecca Way's 4th birthday party today.
She's 4 years old.
Yep. Emily's not even 2. Where's your bottle? Want your bottle?
I want to do it now. What are you taping?
What are you doing? You're not even filming.
Does it say REC?
Yep.
Okay, it's recording. Let's go down
the
slide.
How do I stop it?
Push it once again and it'll stop.
Okay.
Okay, try to keep it steady. All right, Emily. Let's go down the slide. Are you recording?
Yep.
Okay, let's go down the slide. I'll go down after Emily. First, Emily. It's, you know what the date is today? The date is April 17th, 1989. Come here, Emily. Come here. Let's see the bottle. Renovations on our house. We're about to have renovations on our house. Our house is up here. Up there. Okay.
I can't.
Okay, now come back. Wait, let me see which is the best way to hold it. Yeah, like this.
My arm is getting tired, though.
Like this. This on your shoulder. This here. Don't press the button now.
Why?
Because you want to get ready, okay? And this to sort of hold the camera up, okay? Hold it like here. There. Is that easier? Is
yeah.
that steadier?
Kind of, yeah.
Now look at, there's a thing here you could turn to make it go far away or close.
Is that close?
Okay, now look, is it close or far away? Is that far away or close?
Far away.
Close?
Close.
Far away. Okay. So we'll leave it about middle.
Chris, just this.
Get me?
Push.
Yep.
Emily, come here. Come on, let's go down the swing.
Lock the key.
Where are you?
Oh, good, Emily. Let's have some music. Emily. Em. Emily, come here. One, two. Get her dancing. Come over here.
Necessities or Mother Nature's recipes that bring the fair necessities of life.
Get your hands out from under the floor.
Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be found off my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few.
You eat
ants? Are
you recording?
And you're gonna love the way they tickle. Just move me. Look out!
R.E.C., get your hands over the lens.
Will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Now when you pick a pawpaw or a prickly pear, and
yeah,
you prick a raw paw, well, next
time, Dad, can you
beware.
Stop?
Don't tape over here, okay? Don't tape over there,
Dad.
Don't tape over there. That's why a bear can rest at ease with
the bear of life. Yeah.
Uh-oh, she's
going to
throw a fit.
And you're going to make one well there. Why are you even saying like one?
Emily, where's your bottle?
Why like that?
Of the rich and famous. We're in Tisbury on Martha's Vineyard in 1989. And here we are at the palatial palace of Peter and Marie and Tim and Chris and Emily Larson and also Felix. And we are going to show you, for our viewing audience in television land, our wonderful big
house.
No,
don't touch.
Rain and the snow.
I'm sorry.
And there's the sky.
Here, come with me. Can you find all the birds? Just look for a book.
Come on. There, now back to cornflakes today?
No.
Well, you should, because cornflakes are good for you. They put hair on your chest, hair in your face, and hair all over your body. And they're good for you, Christopher Larson.
Stop it.
No. Well, once upon a time, there was a little old man named Geppetto. And he wanted, so badly did he want a son, that he carved a little puppet, and he called the puppet Pinocchio. One day, Pinocchio went out and had a whale steak at the local restaurant.
Fuck you.
Now that is not right for television. We have Emily with her toys. Oh, Emily.
Did, are you recording?
Well, record.
Mommy!
Well, here we are, and we're gonna have a great time. I'll play little G.I. Joe game for you, and record our game. Now for a thing, I'll introduce the characters.
Go,
recording.
Go.
Snake Eyes.
Go.
His nunchuck.
Go.
Blowgun. Great introduction of G.I. Joe. This is, let me first introduce the characters to you. This is Snake Eyes with his nunchuck, blowgun, and sword. Okay. Now we have, Alley Viper with his shield, and Uzi rifle, and he has a blast helmet, you can see. Here is Annihilator, which is Annihilator, which is helicopter backpack, and you see he doesn't have to always go like this. He wants to go like that, and he doesn't want to go like that, he can go like this. With his Uzi rifle, and see his little steering mechanism right here.
Oh,
and
yeah.
He has a little Uzi right here. As you can see. Here is Storm Shadow, the new version of Storm Shadow. Oh yeah, by the way, this is a new version of Snake Eyes. Storm Shadow with his triple bow and walkie-talkie backpack. Shut up, Cliff. So, there used to be a little thing, but it broke. This is, I don't remember his name, but he came in the Night Raven, and I call him Black Knight. He has an Uzi and a gas equipment backpack. See, has a little gas mask right here, little tubes. Here is Repeater, and he has a quite big gun. In the game, you can consider it almost like a bazooka. And we had a little thing that it hooked on to right here, but I can't find that. And he has a signal backpack with this little antenna. I have Charbroil. I have a new one that with a helmet. He looks much better with a helmet. I might be using him instead of this guy. It's just like this, and he has a
Uzi and an aimer. I mean, an M16 with an aimer and a jetpack. And I just like to show you, I had these scrap pieces, like guys with no legs that I never used, and I decided to make some people out of them, and I made two pretty good looking guys, see? Call this guy Mix Up, and see, this is made out of all different guys, as you can see, green front, gray, and that, and all those things is mixed up, okay? And I made him, and I call him Hurricane. I mean, Mix Up. And I made this guy. His name is Hurricane. And I like this. I especially like this arm right here. It came from a bat. And you can connect all sorts of guns on there. They have like special things because it went to a robot. And I call him Hurricane. And these guys are mostly on the same team. I'm gonna say, yeah, these are all on the same team, but they're gonna be they're like guys, scientists, they're working for scientists, and scientists are trying to go after. The only one left, all the others are extinct. Boglin. Boglin, see? And these are on his team, they're like hiding out in a tunnel, and these guys all have to find him. And this is a very ferocious creature. It has to be kept in a cage. Sorry, folks. Just don't have this stuff ready. Like this. And that'll be sitting right here. I'm just cleaning it up. I'll be back in just a second. Guarding him.
Thank you.
I'm just getting a new charbroil. Oh yeah, and this is a new one that I was talking about with his helmet. See, which head do you like better? I prefer this one, so we're not gonna use him. And well, that's the game. Okay. Oh yeah, wait. Stop that. Stop. Dr. Van Geyser? Dr. Van Gooser? And Dr. Van Victor? So, the game begins. This is our office, by the way. Oh, the yellow part. Can't see it, but right there. Got any missions for us today, sir? Well, actually, I do. I would like you and your squad team to go find me the last and only living Boglin. A Boglin? Aren't those those ferocious things I've seen in movies sometimes? Well, I don't know about that, sir. I mean, I could lose some men in that mission. I know, it's dangerous, but there's a reward. And there's millions of scientists all over the United States looking for that very exact same monster. We'll think about it. Oh, yes, and by the way, there are two guardians of the Boglins. Their name are Riplash and Bong Bong. This is Riplash, and this is Bong Bong. Okay? We'll think about it, me and my men. Okay, bye. Hey guys, one of the scientists, Dr. Van Geet. Oh yeah, let's take it. Well, actually, you should find out what the mission is. Our mission is to go find the last and only living Boglin. Whoa, that's, I don't know about that, sir. Aren't those ferocious things that, yes, in our movies? Yes, Boglins are things I've seen in movies? Yes, they are. As a matter of fact, it's the exact same thing I said when I talked to Van Vegan Ether. Well, I think we should. I mean, we haven't done a lot of things for him late. We haven't done very much things for him late. Have we? No, actually, we haven't. Well, let's go tell the rest of the team.
Okay. Yep, the answer is yes. Yes, let's go, guys.
Stop!
No!
Well, Dr. Van Geeser and Dr. Geyser, Dr. Van Hooser, and Dr. Van Victor, our answer is yes.
Yeah, we'll take it. Yeah, we'll take your job, sure.
Cool, get on. Uh-oh.
Stop. Oh, goody, goody, goody. Well, we were just having a guest here talking about our mission. We thought you'd say yes.
Oh, yeah, well, we did.
Our answer is yes. Okay, good. Well, when can you start your mission? Anytime you want. Well, you just started. Okay, goodbye, goodbye. They're running around, you know. Well, I wonder where that Baldwin is. Yeah, so do I, man. This is really creepy out here, and I want to get home before supper, man. I'm sorry, but I'm supposed to be home in about a month. Oh, no, man. I'm going to miss, like, what? 31 suppers? Oh, my God. That's bad. Yeah, I know it is. Well, we have some food with us. Good. Okay, let's go. Hey, guys! I think I found him!
What? What? You found him? You found him? Yeah, yeah. Where is he?
Right there! Ah, get him back! Ah! Taking me, Dad. I got him! Yay! Uh-oh, we better watch out. His owners might be pretty mad.
Hey, what are you doing? Like, hey, man, he's not blocking me. He's not man.
Hey, man, get off me, man. I'm cool, you know what I mean? Ah!
Whoa!
after my friend. My arm! Oh! What the? I've practiced for many years with a sword like this. Why? Ow! Hey, man! That's like totally uncool!
Tell us the rest. Oh!
oh no, my tooth came out. Whoosh, his tooth came out right here. Whoosh, and it was holding on to this guy, so he came out with it. Whoosh. He'll put it in his mouth and it'll blow up. Da, 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 da. Come up. Yum, yum. Pretty yummy. Now I can put my tooth under my pillow if I can just find it. Let's see. Rush it under. No one tried to push me off. Get off me. Get up! I missed! All the bullets go. Oh, I'm burning! Quick, push me over. I don't want to suffer. Bye, friend! You'll never get away with that! You'll never! I'll kill you all! I'll die! I got him! Yay! Clap, clap, clap. Let's give him some gas! Chomp. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Ah! That was pretty yummy. Stop! Get him! Wait, I know what the man said before he died. Swallow the backpack, and the pressure will blow up when he bites it, just like in that movie I saw. Jaws! Do it! Actually, first we need someone to make him open his mouth with. The scientist! I'm here and I'm willing to sacrifice my life to kill this Boglin and to kill too many of your team. Then jump for him! Ah, chomp, 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 choo, choo, choo. He's dead. Yum, yum. Oh no, we missed! Oh no, he's gonna belch! Yeah! Here, what's this? Pressure? Quick, cut him open. They could be still there. Hey, look at, he didn't chew him up enough. They're still alive. Just like in the movie I saw, Little Red Riding Hood. Hey, get them all out before he blows up again. Remember, there's two in there. Yum, yum. Now push them over the side. One, two, three, push. Push. And the scientist and his well-paid team lived happily ever after with Dr. Van Geezer, who had come back and had a medal pinned right on his chest for glory and...
Thank you.
gonna show this, are you?
Keep dancing. I'll be right back.
Dance, man. Okay, sweetie.
Emily, can you dance with Timmy?
I'm getting to know you. I'm going to know you.
Smash his head.
No! 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 No!
on me? What? What did I tell you it is?
Friend, the one who loves you best is the king. All that bowing and kowtowing to remind you of your royalty, I find a most disgusting exhibition. I wouldn't ask a Siamese cat to demonstrate his loyalty by taking that ridiculous position. How would you like it if you were a man playing the part?
Disappear in this sinner!
It's Emily! Emily's gonna crush you against the stove! Stick your head in the stove and it'll bite your head off!
No!
Oops.
Hi. This is Timmy, and this is Emily, and I'm gonna tell a joke for you. Actually, yeah, one joke. Wait, no. Yeah, one joke. Okay. Here it is. Well, there's an Indian tribe, and the chief can't fart. So one of his messengers goes to a general store and he says, "Big chief, no fart." And the guy says, "Well, give him a can of beans." So he gives him a can of beans, comes back the next day and says, "Big chief, no fart." So he goes, "Well, give him 10 cans of beans." So he goes home, gives him 10 cans of beans, comes back the next day and says, "Big chief, no fart." And he goes, "We'll give him 50 cans of beans." So he goes home, gives him 50 cans of beans, and he comes back the next day and he goes, "Big chief, no fart." And he goes, "We'll give him 100 cans of beans." So he goes home, gives him 100 cans of beans, and then he comes back the next day and he goes, "Big fart, no chief." And that's my joke.
That's good.
And see what happened is, big fart, no chief. And there's another one. Oh yeah! Okay, well, there's these ants, and they're like in a camp, and they're bragging about where they've been and everything. And one guy goes, "Well, I went and climbed into a big black cave, and a big brown smelly bear chased me out." Get it?
Yeah.
temple bell? Am I right?
Big Bird?
No, that's Emily.
That's Emily, right. How old are you, Emily?
1, 2, 3.
You're 3? You will be 3 soon.
And who do you like to play with? Did you show Daddy the big sticker on your pants?
Hey, Dad.
That's a brand size sticker. Abby, show us your eyes. Where are your eyes?
Where are your eyes?
The front eye closed.
Okay, where's your nose?
Show us on your face. No, show us on your real face. That's right. Where are your ears? That's right. And where's your chin? And where's your tongue? And where's your hair? Oh, what pretty curls you have. And that mummy has curls too, huh? Temporarily.
Okay.
You're going to play some more music? Tell us about your music box.
Music box?
Yeah, tell us something about your music box.
Thank you.
5. Okay, let's get ready for Pussycat on parade. Ready?
Beautiful.
He's a star.
Dazzle, it's a funnest in town.
Yee-haw! Ooh, I'm a movie star.
You're not going to show us our cousin, are you? My name is Tim, and I'm here to say I'm in the biggest rapper in the U.S. of A.
I'm getting up!
Good.
Okay,
you're
not
going to show us to anyone besides
the Larsons!
Is that your favorite ornament?
Want to see my favorite?
Yeah.
Let me put in a pie so we can all see it. How about right here?
okay?
Bear, he's a beautiful fish. Swimming in the waters of Martha's Vineyard.
Look.
I'm gonna put that one up.
Mad and try and go.
game?
Oh, Nintendo Power. It's about a lot of things.
How about the one called The Game of Life?
Oh, yeah.
February 1990, and we're going going to show you Timothy Lorsden's fifth grade science project. The project was carried out over several months and involved a project involving the universe. Timothy is now going to explain a little bit about the project. Timothy, could you tell us what your science teacher wanted you to do?
Well, she wanted me to do something about the solar system, because we've been studying the solar system lately, and then we have to do a project, and I did one. It could do anything. It could be telescopes, anything to do with the solar system, astronomy. And I did something about all the four planets. See, as you can see here, I have two more, five, two. This is the fifth grade. And I did some facts about all the things, like the number of moons, and I have Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto, and I have all the names over here. Some, like Saturn has 17, so all its names are right here. All that. And I have facts, the distance from the sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and a way to remember that the way from the planets to the, from the sun to the end is my Mercury, very Venus, educated Earth, mother Mars, just Jupiter, served Saturn, us Uranus, Neptune, nine pickles Pluto. And that's from the sun would be like right here. Then these are the way the planets go out, and this is a distance from the sun. This is the average temperature when the sun is shining on that side, like in daytime on the planet, the average temperature. Like Earth, the average is 20 degrees. And I have the diameter in kilometers. That's the way around the equator of the planet. I have the rotation time, the time it takes for the one day. Like Earth is 20, it's, we say it's 24 hours, but it's actually exactly 23 hours and 56 minutes.
So if you lived on Mercury, you would have a very...
On Mercury, a day on Mercury is 59 Earth days here. So it's like...
So you would have a long time in school if you spent half your day in school.
Yeah. And the revolution time is the time it takes to get around the sun. Like, that's like how long a year is. Like, Earth's year is 365 days. Mm-hmm. Saturn, it takes Pluto to get around the sun. So that's like 1 year in Pluto is 248 Earth years. And this is the gods. The Mercury is the god of speed. Venus is the god of love. Earth is no god. Mars is the god of war because it's the red planet. Jupiter is the king of all gods because it's the largest planet. Saturn is the god of agricultural. Uranus is the sky god. Neptune is the god of the sea, and Pluto is the god of the dead.
There's certainly a lot of information in that.
It took me a long time to do this too, so give me some credit.
And we notice up here in the corner...
And I had to fill up a little more space, like the Jupiter's great red spot. You could fit easily, with a little more space, one whole Earth into Jupiter's tiny red spot. Well, red spot is planet. You could fit one Earth in it and have lots of room left over. And this is... My name of my project is Our Solar System, and Mrs. Gatchell, my science teacher, gave me an A on it. And I think that it's a good grade.
Yeah, it sounds like it deserved an A. Now, before we look inside, could you tell us something about how you made the planets? Were they made out of rubber or plastic, or how did you make the planets, and how did you make your solar system?
Well, I took this box. See.
Mm-hmm. We'll look inside in a moment. What did you make the,
I, to make the planets, I used, well, I mean, I made them out of clay, but some, like, Jupiter's the largest planet, so I didn't want to waste a lot of clay. So I took a croquet ball, covered it in clay, I screwed a little eye in it, a little thing, and I hung it from the top of the box. So then, I did Saturn, I used, oh yeah, a bathtub toy, and it's hollow, and
very ingenious.
Jupiter is very heavy, and like Mercury is pretty big, so I didn't want to waste that much clay, so I put a bouncy ball around it, and I painted them all, and did you, here's some of the effects I didn't have. Then there's four planets with rings.
Could we move this chair? I could look at the fact sheet that's in the front.
Oh yeah. Right here is where the planets are in the solar system. See, the first one in the middle, this is the solar system. There's nine planets in the solar system. And the first one is the sun. But if you were the sun, well, and if Pluto is right there, then Neptune is the second one out. And Pluto is the one farthest from the sun.
Mm-hmm.
It's the, then Neptune is the one second farthest. Uranus is the third farthest. Saturn is the fourth. Jupiter is the fifth. Mars the sixth. Earth the seventh. Venus the eighth. And Mercury is the ninth. And then that's, Mercury is the closest to the sun.
Right.
So that's the hottest hottest planet, and it sits it up here. And on here, this is, says which one is, okay, sure, I'll show you what my project now.
And there's all the colors that you told us about, of the planets. Okay, and now let's take a look inside at the solar system.
If you were the sun, this is what you would be seeing. See, the first is white, it's right there, that is Mercury. And that, if you were the sun, see, remember Mercury's the closest to the
right.
sun. So it's right there, and first it's white, it's Mercury. Then the second from the sun is pink, right there, that's Venus. And that, and this is about how big they are. Third from the sun is blue and green, is Earth, right there. And then the fourth is red, is Mars, right there. And the fifth is orange, is Jupiter. And see how big it is? I wouldn't want to waste all that clay, so I used a croquet ball. And see, if you turn it, you can see that's about how big the red spot is. And see how much time you could fit one Earth inside that? See, that's
very
the Earth
impressive.
Right there. And then the fifth is orange, that's Jupiter. The sixth is yellow, Saturn. See right there with the ring around it?
The ring, yes.
And the reason that one that's really noticeable is Saturn. So I made that one with a ring. The seventh is yellow and greenish. It's Uranus, which is right there. That's Uranus. And that has a bouncy ball inside it because I didn't really want to waste the clay to do this. And then the eighth is darker green. It's Neptune. And that used to be right there. I don't know where it was. Neptune is a tad smaller than Uranus. And the ninth is Pluto, which is the coldest and the farthest from the sun, right there.
Blue.
And it's blue. See, ninth is blue, Pluto. And that's my...
Ah.
Oh, neat.
That's very neat.
And that is my project.
Well, thank you, Timmy, for showing us your fifth grade science project. Thank you very much, and we hope to see many more, which we will record. Good night.